Tell God and the whole world I know about you. You're my name. doors open and everybody turns around to see you walk down the aisle in your pretty white gown. You're holding your daddy's arm, your tears begin to fall, and both of our lives about to change forever. Everybody stands, she reaches out a hand, the preacher says, gathered here today. And I almost lose it when I hear you say I do. And I'm so in love with you, baby. I almost lose it when I see that pretty face. It's more than I can take. I wonder if she's nervous, she get cold feet. She wears a smile as the diamond shines from a wedding ring. I hope it's everything you wanted. You deserve the best. Always knew I'd be the reason for your wedding dress. So beautiful the way you read your vows. Then the wedding.
First, I want to welcome everyone to beautiful Mexico. Bienvenidos a México, lindo y querido. Tried a little something there, right? Thank you to your videographer for that. On behalf of Judy and Tim, thank you so much for making the journey. We have family and friends from Texas, home to Astros, Florida, California, Arizona, Virginia, and Colorado. So thank you for coming out. And now for the reason that we all made the trip, to celebrate the union of Tim and Judy. But what does marriage mean? Tim, your wife is there to have your back during success and failure, to be your support and push you to be a better man. And when you fall down, Judy will be there to take a picture and share with the rest of us so we can all laugh. What else would a tattletale do? Better yet, a criminal spray tan trafficker. Little things there. And Judy, when you're stressed from work or your favorite boba spot closes down, Tim will be there to listen and support you or try a new tapioca spot with you. He's your lobster and your dim comes cart pusher. But seriously, listen first. If she wants your advice, she'll ask. A lot of the time, men are very solution driven. Sometimes women simply want to vent, learn to recognize the difference. And for both of you, truly listen to one another. Focus on what's being said. Ask questions. Be sure of things. Assumptions kill good communication and good relationships. Allow room for growth. You'll both help one another grow as individuals and together grow as a couple. But marriage is more than two people. And that's why we're also happy to be here to celebrate with you guys, right? While you cannot let anyone come between your union, having family and friends there to support you during your marriage is truly helpful. Those of you here with us, I ask you that you take a vow to support these two in their life journey together. There are a few other things you should keep in mind as you embark on a life together. First, marriage is a commitment. Commitment is defined as a state or quality of being dedicated to a cause. Being dedicated, right? Dedication, what do we think of? Nipsey Hussle's hook for his song, Dedication, goes, dedication, hard work plus patience. Think about that. Hard work. Don't let anyone tell you marriage isn't hard work. Sure, there are a ton of fun moments and carefree joys, but anything worthwhile takes hard work. I know you two are here today because you've committed to putting in the hard work, the effort. Then he says, plus patience. Jennifer and I will celebrate our 7th wedding anniversary later this month. You guys did a good job picking Mexico in November versus us being super cold. Good job. I'm not gonna worry about sweating this much. Trust me, she'll tell you that being married to me takes a lot of patience. I'd like to think I'm patient too, for the record. You guys have been dating for 7+ years? Tim, 9 plus years? Well, that's 7 plus, right? I'm confident that you know one another. Not the casual, superficial, oh, he's cute, she's fine, we have the same favorite color type of relationship. This is a deep core level, what makes this person tick kind of love. You've had fights, you've worked through them, you're standing in front of us today. And what is love without patience? Try always to be patient with one another. Tim forgot to pay the electricity bill, and Judy, you're at home in the dark. Patience. Judy's hair products, makeup, and lotion creeping across your side of the vanity. Patience. The world is impatient. Make sure you two are each other's steady and patient support. What I do know is that I've watched you two grow as a couple and as people. Tim, you've come a long way. Kidding. But seriously, you've matured together. I know you'll be successful in marriage because you have the same goals. Make a bunch of money, have a bunch of kids. No? All right. You can do that later. Enjoy marriage with one another. Get to know each other better in that new space. And if, you know, when you want to add 1, 2, 3, 5 kids, you know, it's fine. We'll be here to help out. So, as an officiant, I get to vent and give advice, but y'all aren't here to listen to me. We're here to get married, right? Okay. And again, we're so honored that you chose to share this moment with us. Judy and Tim have prepared vows that they want to share with one another.
My Babe Tim. My whole life, I've always searched for someone that would truly love me for who I am. Someone that would make me feel safe. Someone that would show an immense amount of patience. And someone that I could laugh with and at for hours. You embody all those things and more. I love the way you care for me, our friends, family. I love that you're a great dog father to our pups Boba and Rusty. I love how supportive and motivating you are. Not to mention, I love how handsome and fine you are. I would not be the person I am today without you cheering me on and staying by my side. These past 9 years together has taught me how to communicate with one another. It has shown me that we share the same values and goals in life, and also to pick each other up when either of us are feeling down. I knew immediately that we could overcome anything once we survived many Houston hurricanes, floods, and an entire pandemic, being in the same damn household for all those days without ripping each other apart. Tim, I wanted to thank you for literally being my biggest rock and support system throughout the toughest times in our lives, with career changes, mental breakdowns, and just life itself. Your words of encouragement and positive words of affirmations is something that has lifted me up, and I will always appreciate and cherish you. I promise to stay patient, even if it means waiting for you to finish up a game on your PS5 or you needing to finish your hair. I promise to have your back and support you through thick and thin, and that's thick with 3 Qs. I promise to give you random hugs and do silly trendy dances at 1 a.m. in the morning. I promise I will try to share my chips and candy with you on the weekends. I promise to make you happy as much as you have made me. And I promise to laugh with you and care for you and love you always, unconditionally. I can't wait for all the travels, concerts, and food adventures we'll have in the near future. And I can't wait to see you become a wonderful father to our children and third puppy. Just like Phoebe said in Friends, it's a known fact that lobsters fall in love and mate for life. So to my husband, Tim, I just wanted to say I love you and that you're my lobster.
That's a hard To the love of my life, Judy, 9 years ago, I made the most important decision of my life that has led to this very moment. But back then, I'm sure both of us were just looking to have fun. And damn, we did. We ain't gonna talk about that. It's been a whirlwind being with you, a good whirlwind. But 2 years ago, without your blessing, I made the second most important decision that has me standing here in front of you. I want to thank you for loving all of me. And what I mean by that is, you know, most people know me as this goofy, carefree, and dumb individual. I mean, almost everyone here has a story about me. Probably has a video or picture of me doing something ridiculous, or you shared it. But don't get me wrong, you think that too of me. But you also see me at my lowest and my worst points of life. And never wavered. You stayed loving, supportive through every obstacle, and you continue to do so, and always been my rock. Just being with you makes everything better. And I recall before, when we weren't living together, you would be there for me 2 a.m., 3 a.m. if I was down. But the fact that you're by my side every day, I don't have moments like that no more because I'm with you. As for you, what more can I say? Besides being gorgeous, beautiful, sexy, every adjective in the dictionary, and the reason why I'm truly in love and with you, it's very important. I love you for the laughter and joy that you bring into my life, the people you have brought into my life. I cannot state how proud of you, that I am, of the person you've become. I've been there from the beginning when you started your career. To see the growth in your life has been incredible, and how you affected all the people around you, the people that are here, the people in my life and in your life, literally the life of the party without the need of an ounce of alcohol. To you, Judy, I promise to always love you, feed you, and provide you with all the food imaginable in the world, to get you boba when it's your time, and continue to go on numerous adventures with you. And of course, I'll add this in, but continue loving Boba and Rusty and that third puppy. Now I get to finish what began 9 years ago and make the third most important decision in my life and solidify us in front of all our family and friends. Judy, I love you with all my heart and can't wait to spend the rest of my life with you.
All right, and now we have to do the legal part. Tim, do you take Judy to be your wife? Do you promise to love, honor, cherish, and protect her, forsaking all others, and holding on to her forevermore?
I do.
And Judy, do you take Tim to be your husband? Do you promise to love, honor, cherish, and protect him, forsaking all others, and holding on to him forevermore?
I diddly do.
Judy and Tim will now exchange rings as a symbol of love and commitment to each other. Rings are a precious metal. They are also made precious by you wearing them. Your wedding rings are special. They enhance who you are. They mark the beginning of your long journey together. Your wedding ring is a circle, a symbol of love never ending. It is a seal of the vows you've just taken to love each other without end. Tim, please place the rings on Judy's left hand and repeat after me. As a sign of my love,
as a sign of my love,
that I have chosen you above all else,
that I have chosen you above all else,
with this ring I thee wed.
With this ring I thee wed.
And Judy, please place a ring on Tim's left hand and repeat after me. As a sign of my love,
as a sign of my love.
That I have chosen you above all else.
That I have chosen you above all else.
With this ring, I thee wed.
With this ring, I thee wed.
And now, by the power vested in me, it is my honor and delight to declare you married. You may now kiss the bride. I am so pleased to present the newlyweds, Mr. and Mrs. Tim and Judy Tai.
They tell me I should fix my grill cause I got money now. I ain't gon' sit around in front like I ain't thought about it. A perfect smile is more appealing, but it's funny how my shit is crooked, look at how far I done got without it. I keep my twisted grill just to show the kids it's real. We ain't picture perfect, but we worth the picture still. I got smart, I got rich, and I got bitches still. And they all look like my eyebrows, thick as hell. Love yourself, girl, or nobody will. Though you a woman, I don't know how you deal with all the pressure to look impressive and go out in heels. I feel for you, killing yourself to find a man that'll kill for you. You wake up, put makeup on, stare in the mirror, but it's clear that you can't face what's wrong. No need to fix what God already put his paintbrush on. Your roommate yelling, why you gotta take so long? What it's like to have a crooked smile.
I'm away, I'm away, I'm away down. I'm away, I'm away, I'm away down.
This crooked smile.
The one that was trying to keep me way down. Like the sun, no, you know I'm on my way down.
So all the women with the flaws know it's hard, my darling. You wonder why you're lonely and your man's not calling. You keep falling victim cause you're insecure. And when I tell you that you're beautiful, you can't be sure. Cause he don't seem to want you back and it's got you asking. So all you see is what you lack and not what you packing. Take it from a man that loves what you got. And baby girl, you a star, don't let him tell you you're not. Now is it real? Eyebrows, fingernails, hair, is it real? If it's not, girl, you don't care. Cause what's real is something that the eyes can't see, that the hands can't touch, that them bras can't be in that shoe. Never let them see your friend. And if you need a friend to pick you up, I'll be around. And we can ride with the windows down, the music loud. I can tell you ain't laughed in a while, but I wanna see that crooked smile.
I'm away, I'm away, I'm away down. I'm away, I'm away, I'm away down.
Crooked smile, we can style on
them.
Crooked smile, we can style on them.
You were the one that was trying to keep me way down. But like the sun, no, you know I'm on my way back.
We don't look nothing like the people on the screen. You know the movie stars, picture perfect beauty queens. But we got dreams and we got the right to chase them. Look at the nation, that's a crooked smile. Braces couldn't even straighten. Seem like half the race is either on probation or in jail. Wonder why we inhale, cause we inhale already. I ask if my skin pale, would I then sell like Eminem or Adele? Well, one more time for the veil. And fuck all of that beef shit, nigga, let's make a meal. Hey, officer, man, we don't want nobody getting killed. Just open up that cell, let my brother out of jail. I got money for the bail now, and well now. If you're asking, will I tell now? Hey, hell nah, I ain't snitching cuz. Man, they get them niggas stitches now. If you was around and you wouldn't need a witness now. How you like this crooked smile?
I'm away, I'm away, I'm away down. I'm away, I'm away, I'm away down.
That crooked smile.
You're the one that was trying to keep me way down. But like the sun, no, you know I'm coming way back round.
Crooked smile, we can style on them. Crooked smile, we can style on them.
You were the one that was trying to keep me way down. But like the sun, no, you know I'm coming way back round.
Something up.
Tonight I'm fucking something.
I need roll call. Did you hear I would?
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Show up, show up.
Show up, show up.
Pow up, pow up.
Pow up, pow up.
You missed an essay. I clean it up.
Yeah,
when
nobody.
Wanna be, girl, let me be. I wanna be everything your man's not. And I'm gonna give you every little thing I got. Cause you are more than a man needs. That's why I say you're truly my destiny. I'm gonna get you if it takes me until forever. No, you don't feel me if forever turns into never. I'll let you know my love is just that strong. And for you, never just ain't that long. Ooh. I wanna be the smile you put on your face.
Yeah.
I wanna be your hands when you say your
say
grace.
Baby.
I wanna be whatever is your favorite place.
Girl.
Oh, I just wanna be close,
close to
I
you.
I wanna be the hat you put on your head.
Can I
wanna
be
the sheet you put on your bed. And even if the day turns into night, I will love you by candlelight. And even if the water starts to pour,
come on, ladies, hear me out. Give it up. Give it up.
Put you on my shoulders. Ooh,
yeah. Hey, how's everyone doing tonight? Hey, I hope you're having a good time tonight. Make sure y'all drink up because everything's on Tim tonight.
Yeah.
All right, hey. My name is Andy, and according to the groom, I'm a degenerate. He sure knows how to pick his friends, am I right? I've known Tim for about a decade now, and we've grown closer and closer over the years. I can't recall the exact time that I met Tim, because I felt like he's been there all along since day one. He's the type of person that you can click with, and he's been a lifelong friend. You know he can be a lifelong friend. Yeah. He's the most chill and down-to-earth guy you can ever meet. He'll never say no. There's been the times when I'd come over and be like, hey, Tim, you want to go to the casino? It'd be at midnight. We'll leave Houston, and then we just head over there, and I'll be like, hey, it's been a couple hours, you know? And we both knew that was a lie. Right, you know, but on these trips, we would have long, deep talks, and Tim would talk about everything, and the way he would talk about Judy, you knew that she was the one, right? Hey, Joe. Throughout the relationship, I was always the third wheel, but sometimes Judy got mistaken for it. In all those moments I spent with them, I've never questioned what it was, like if they had true love between them two. The way Tim would talk about her, the way Tim would look at her, you can tell he really loved her. Judy, you look absolutely stunning. Judy, you're full of life and full of spice. I knew you were the perfect woman for Tim because you found out he would eat his chocolate chip cookies with ketchup. And you still loved him. You still loved him after all that.
A long time ago.
Is it still?
No.
Tim, it's an honor to be your best man. I've seen how supportive you've been of Judy and how selfless you've been throughout your whole relationship. I wish you nothing but the best, and I'm so glad that you two are together, and I love y'all so much. And wait, before this, I want to end this speech off with a quote from The Office. Hold on. I can't. All right, Webster's Dictionary. Webster's Dictionary defines a wedding as the fusing of two metals with a hot torch. Well, you know something? I think you guys are two metals. Gold medals. Hey, a toast to the tie.
All right. Hi, everyone. So good to see all of you. My name's Steffi, and I'm the maid of honor because, hey! Because I've known Judy since we were 5 years old, which is pretty much our entire lives. And growing up, I'd spend almost every weekend at her house. And the first thing I'd have to do when I walk through the door is greet Mrs. Chan. Mrs. Chan, with an IE haul. And she'd immediately respond back with a quai, which for those who don't know means good kids. And that's who we were growing up. We were good kids, even though we thought we were super rebellious. But our idea of being rebellious meant going to co-ed birthday parties that our parents knew about and having these super long 5-hour multi-way phone calls with a lot of people in this room. And we'd prank call everyone we could, including the Domino's pizza guy. And we'd go, meow, and then hang up the phone. And we thought that was a super cool thing to do. But turns out we were just really annoying. And ultimately, Guai Guai Kids. And to be honest, not much has changed because Judy, you are such a beautifully good person. You are kind, generous, loyal, honest, and one of the best people that I know. So when you called me one day and you were like, hey, I met this guy named Tim partying at a bar, I was like, yeah. I was like, who is this party boy that Judy's trying to date? But, you know, as I watched you guys grow together, I was like, okay, this makes sense. But there was one day that I remember thinking, oh, actually, Judy really did find her person. And it was actually at Andy and Jennifer's wedding way back in 2014. Yeah. Andy and Jennifer, they were making their way around the tables, and they were coming to get their toast, and they were coming over to our table, and Judy was starting to get really nervous, okay? And then Tim was like, actually, you know, I want to give the toast, and he volunteers himself. And me and Judy give each other a look, and all the girls, we give each other a look, like, is this a good idea, this new boyfriend giving a toast? But he proceeded to give this beautiful speech about how much he respected Andy and Jennifer's partnership, how much he admired their love and support for one another. And then he ends it by saying, I can only hope to be where you guys are one day and to have what you guys have. Yeah, I know. And I remember thinking to myself, aw, and I look over at Judy and she's just sobbing like she is right now. And I was like, oh, this is the guy. She's found her person. And I knew at that moment I'd be up here today giving this speech about this exact moment. And too bad it was 8 years later. And I've really had to hold that secret in for a long time, okay? But you know, through these years, y'all have really grown together. And I've watched as you guys have loved and supported one another unequivocally. And so now I'm the one who's up here that can say, I admire and respect your partnership, and we'd all be so lucky to have what you guys have. Okay? So, join me, everyone, raise your glasses to Judy and Tim, and may they have many Guai Guai kids in the future. Cheers.
So I'd like to first, not yet. I'd like to first and foremost thank all our family and friends that were able to make this evening to celebrate Judy and Tim's union, right? As all of you guys know or don't know, I am Judy's older brother, right? Wait. If y'all didn't know, Judy and I are roughly 8.5 years apart, right? Oh, I know. I was thinking the same thing. Like, damn, it's a pretty far distance. Mom and Dad had one too many Coronas and decided to keep her. That's why she's laughing. That's why she's laughing. She's like, I guess I'll keep her, right? Because if my parents said no, who was I gonna be like, who would I dunk over, right? Who was I gonna blame when I broke something? Because I blamed her for every damn thing in the world. Now, when it came to Judy's dating life, I knew very little of it. Could have been because I was overprotective, right? The brother who would scare every single guy who would come in. They dropped her 30 minutes late from the movies, and I would come out of my wife beater and be like, what the? She knows exactly what I'm talking about, okay? Could it be? No. However, June 2013 is when it all turned. She told me she was interested in someone. She met through Antho, wherever you're at. I love you, brother. I had no idea who this guy was. Right, and all I told her was, he better not be a scrub. Which, by the way, Judy played No Scrub by TLC for almost 2 years, back to back to back to back, and she wouldn't stop playing it, and I hate that effing song. So, no, this is PG-13, I'm sorry. But, however, she did talk really highly of this guy named Timothy Ty. Logan, relax. I gotta read a speech, right? So, where was I? So she talked really highly of him prior to us meeting, right? I had no expectations, but she did speak highly of him, and I guess that sealed the deal when I finally met him that July. He drank with me. He played beer pong with me, and I think he's gonna be my beer pong partner for the rest of the life. Tell me that's right. Hey, last cup's the easiest cup. Is that right? Hey, shout out to Trizzy. Hey, all right, so here you go. But through the years, I've gotten to know Tim more as a brother. He has proven to me and my family to be very respectful, fun-loving, intelligent, and most importantly, he treated Judy very, very well, right? So Tim, I wanted to drop a quick tip for you, all right? When they say happy wife, happy life, I thought they were kidding, bro. But that shit is true, all right? Tim, remember that blackjack table? With Kim Mai, all right? Just remember her. She told us what to do, when to do, and every time she did that, what happened? We got a hashtag what? Thank you. So every time, hey, you think that was an easy bust, but ain't gonna easy bust. Good luck. All right, Tim, I'm glad to call you my brother. Welcome to the family. Judy, I love you. Let's cheers to this happy couple, man. Let's go, baby.
I love you.
Drink up. All right, Jen.
Oh, let's go.
Cheers. Oh, cheers, 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 cheers. Jen, Ty, you up?
Taylor.
Hey.
I
love you, Judy and Uncle Tim.
I love you, Judy and Uncle Tim.
Okay.
Okay, so I don't know why y'all had me decide to close it out, but here I am. So I'm Tim's sister, Jennifer. Oh! is Jennifer Taylor, formerly Ty. Tim is expecting a roast, so I'm going to get that out of the way real quick. So Tim, when he was little, would play with his poop. Right? You remember that? Okay. Play with his poop. John will vouch for that. Brooklyn. Tim will draw all over his face with a green Expo marker. So that's okay. He knows how to turn off his brain. Tim needs help with his English. So that's okay. Okay. Where are all these kids around me? And Tim was just that little annoying kid that used to bother me when his sister wanted to just read her books, right? So she... still happening, still very annoying. Tim's expecting a roast coming from me, but like, this is my little brother. I don't cry, so this is a lot. So y'all know I don't cry, so this means a lot that my little brother found someone like Judy to come and take care of him so I don't have to anymore. and make sure he's good for life. Like, they're the best aunts and uncles to Brooklyn. I don't think anyone was expecting this because I don't cry. That too. But I'm so thankful for Judy and Tim coming together because we doubted them initially, right? Like, no, hold on. We weren't expecting them to move in together. JT and I both were advising against that, but they proved us all wrong. And they're here today together. And again, the best aunt and uncle to Brooklyn. Brooklyn loves Judy more than you. Okay. No, she doesn't. No, but I'm so thankful to have a sister-in-law. Judy has two Jennifers in her life now. So I'm just so thankful to have her in my life, and thank you for taking care of Tim. Tim's a huge part of my life, and he's a little strange, but you wanted to marry him, so that's okay. But at the end of the day, Tim and I are only 5 years apart, but he is my little brother, and so I want to make sure he's well taken care of because you're going to be stuck with him for life, so I don't have to take care of him anymore. So good luck. But cheers.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's give a big applause. You've been grabbing, crushing my life. There isn't anything or anyone that I could be, and it just wouldn't feel right. If I didn't have you by my side. Oh.
were there for me to love and care for me when skies were gray. Whenever I was down, you were always there to comfort me. And no one else can be what you have been to me. You will always be, you will always be the girl in my life for all time. Mama, mama, you know
thank you very much, everyone. Thank you very much.
When you say you know.
Ready?
Never had a moment where I ever questioned you. You already know that. I ain't never stressed with ya. Money and you own that. That's why I'm so impressed with ya. I'm my best with ya, yeah. You know you're my heart.
They wanna take care. You on my shoulders.
Ooh, yeah.
And if it's hard for you to get to sleep,
I will.
I'll sing you a melody.
Yes, I will.
I wanna feel this way till the end of time. Cause I pray one day that you will be mine.
I wanna be the smile you put on
your smile.
Face.
Yeah.
I wanna be the hat you put on your
Can I
head.
Cover you?
I wanna be the sheet you put on
Can
your
Can I wrap my
bed.
Love around you?
I wanna
you.
Be the skirt wrapped around your legs.
Yeah, yeah,
oh,
yeah.
I just wanna be close.
I wanna be close. See, my life is filled
life is
with
filled.
Ups and downs.
And now
I'm okay.
I'm okay
when you're around.
Yeah.
And when I'm in a storm,
in a storm,
and my nights are cold, reach out your hand.
Out your hand.
Hold me to hold.
Me to
with love.
Represent your side like me. Round here, if you stick, you catch a hot one. Try shotgun, a couple of them down one. Belvedere in the rear of the club, pulled up on dubs, and we about to go and buy the bar up. So, so, for sure, we ain't playing. Hang with no lames, walk insane.
Hey, where the party at? Girls is on the way with a Bacardi, yeah.
Yes, we do.
Bottles and models talking all of that.
Best outfit, just showing that skin, trying to make it on the spit. Where you been, girl? You and your friend need to come to the back. We got it locked down. Your white t-shirt or a three-piece suit, don't matter what you wear, all that matters is who you with. Some jiggy, some straight grind, all up in the clubs to have a good time.
Hey, where the party at? Girls is on the way for the Bacardi at. Bottles and models talking all in it. No, I can't forget about my
Father of the bride to the lobby now.
Someone wears fucking right around 1:30. Never get the truth really coming as is. Do rags and Tim's, I'm rolling fast is. This little Jag and Ben.
I'm the one with the rims, the one that seem to make more enemies than friends. I'm sliding in past those, both eyes closed, both arms froze, both charms rose with the S-O-S-O-D-E-dot-F. I am bottle, bottle, until there ain't none left. I'm quick to go left, I plays with no rep, I jams no